Good morning, guys. So I wanted to get on here and talk a little bit about your essays. I'm not gonna lie, I'm a little bit disappointed. I had some students in remote who did fabulously. I have a lot of you who haven't turned it in at all. So make sure that you're doing that and getting those things turned in, because if you get a zero for a test grade, it's gonna be real hard to recover from. So one of the main things that I noticed and the root of a lot of your issues is not following directions. I had slides every day. The essay was divided out by part. All of the whole week we worked on it. So there was a lot of opportunities for students to succeed and ask questions about individual portions of the essay. And a lot of you didn't do that. Last week I had 3 Google Meets and I had 2 people show up total to the Google Meets. So that was a little bit disappointing. I can actually see how many people have viewed my videos on YouTube, so I know that a lot of you guys aren't watching the lectures, which are helpful. I do them for a reason, so that you can learn how to do these things correctly. And if you're not watching the lectures, your grades are reflecting it very poorly. And if you are watching the lectures, your grades are phenomenal. So those of you who are doing what you're supposed to be doing, please keep doing so. You guys are doing great and your grades are reflecting it. Pretty much everything that went wrong because you didn't follow directions or watch the lecture. That's really just the root of the issue. So a lot of you made mistakes on your thesis, which my introduction, it was 25 points. So I did 25 points for the intro, the 2 body paragraphs, and then I did another 25 points for just general following directions, grammar, mechanics, things like that, which most of you did okay on. So let's start with talking about the intro and the thesis. The thesis was the main thing. I gave examples of theses. I've given y'all example essays to look through, and a lot of you just got the thesis wrong. I gave you guys sentence stems to use for the thesis. So you should have said, school should start later in the morning because, or school should not start later in the morning because, and then give your 2 arguments that you're gonna make for why school should start later or should not start later. I also gave you guys 3 sources to use, so those were linked in the stream. It's really critical that you guys look in the stream every day. I link important information in there, I link my lecture, I link readings, things like that in there, so please make sure that you're looking in there too, because that's where I give most of my directions. So I gave you guys 3 sources. 2 of them were very heavy towards school starting later in the morning, and 1 of them was the benefits of starting earlier in the morning. So you guys had plenty of resources to get the information that you needed. A lot of you didn't do that, so that's another big problem with following directions. So in the thesis, a lot of you used I and me and we. We don't use personal pronouns in our essays, and I said that in a lecture. It was in one of our helpful Schmoop videos, and it was on the PowerPoint. So that's just another following directions thing. So you should have had used your sentence stems. School should start later in the morning because, and given your 2 arguments, if you would have read the resources, there's a lot of great arguments for that. School should start later in the morning because teenagers need more sleep and students get better grades. So your thesis being successful is setting up your whole essay for success. Once you get to the counter argument, I know a lot of you are confused. If you did it, I gave you credit for it and it was right. That's why it was a fill in the blank on the essay. And we'll go over that more in the future. But most of you did okay on the counter argument. I think it's just getting in that headspace of arguing the opposite of what you believe. So that's just something to work on, not something I'm super concerned about right now. With your body paragraphs, your topic sentence of the first body paragraph should be the first argument you mention in your thesis statement. So if your first argument was teenagers need more sleep, your topic sentence was school should start later in the morning because teenagers need more sleep, then you would have given me 2 concrete details, and those were in those sources. You didn't even have to look for them very hard. I gave you the sources for that. 2 facts about why teenagers need more sleep. And then you were going to give me a commentary. You were going to tell me, this shows that teenagers need more sleep because, and tell me why it shows that. And then you're going to do your closing sentence. And your closing sentence just rehashes your topic sentence. It should say the same thing, just in different wording. I can't stress that enough. And I've said that so many times my head could spin. So just make sure that you're watching my videos and following directions. It's gonna help you so much, and it'll help your grades a lot. So that was mainly the issue with the body paragraphs, was that you didn't follow directions. It's a formula. Topic sentence, two concrete details, commentary, closing sentence. And I gave you guys a lot of opportunities to see examples, plan the essay. So at this point, I don't know what else I can do. You guys aren't getting on Google Meets and asking questions. You're not asking me questions via email. So there's not much I can do to help you if I don't know that you're struggling. I'm good at a lot of things, but mind reading is not one of them. So make sure that you are asking me questions when you need help. Because I think that's what a lot of you would happen. You guys don't get on Google Meets, you don't ask me questions, and then you just do it and you're doing it wrong. And I can't correct you if you wait until the last minute and you do your essay and then it's a grade. So I gave you guys feedback on the comments if you turned it in. If you didn't turn it in, please do that. Please, please, please turn it in. And then we didn't really talk about the conclusion too much. The conclusion is just restating your thesis and giving like a final call to action. So in the conclusion, you could just kind of reword your thesis a little bit and then say something to the extent of, you know, schools kind of maybe connect it back to your hook and intro. If in your hook you talked about, imagine a school day where students are well rested and prepared to learn, you could in your conclusion bring that back. If students started later in the morning, we could have that ideal day where students are well rested and ready to learn. School should start later in the morning because, and give me your reasons. It's really not hard, but I could have given you guys that information if you would get on Google Meets, and I did give it in my lecture, but a lot of you just didn't use the resources that I gave you. So overall, a lot of you guys just need to go back and watch the lectures and view the PowerPoints and watch my videos, because it's very clear to me that most of you who failed did not do that. And don't get me wrong, there are people who failed in person too, but they also didn't follow directions. So it's a common theme across the board. If you are doing what I'm telling you to do and you're telling me when you need help, you should not be failing. I want to help you guys. I had a Google Meet today. I am 3 for 3 on Google Meets with no one showing up. So I don't really have just a whole lot of sympathy for a lot of you guys. And if you're having internet issues, tell me. I don't want that to be what's keeping you from doing things, but I need to know. I can't help you if I don't know what's going on. So just make sure you're getting on Google Meets, asking questions, telling me when you're struggling. But the Google Meets is a big deal. I can count on one hand how many different students I have seen on Google Meets this semester. And it's really only about 4 or 5. And they tend to get on Google Meets every time I offer it. But the last 3 Google Meets, I've had no one attend. So please make sure that you're attending those. As far as essay corrections go, I'm going to allow you guys to rewrite the essay. I'm going to push that out in Google Classroom today or tomorrow maybe. But I'm only going to give y'all, I'm not giving y'all much time to redo it. Use my feedback, watch the lecture, and you can rewrite the whole thing. I'll push out the same graphic organizer that's blank and you can start over. Use my feedback and we will go from there. If you haven't written it yet, do it, please. I'm begging you. I don't want you to fail, but I can't pass you if you don't turn anything in, and a 0 test grade is extremely hard to recover from. So please make sure that you're doing that. And I don't think I have anything else, so I hope you guys have a great day. We're starting Unit 2. It's a great unit. It's about civil rights and social justice. We get to talk about MLK and Selma and the march through Birmingham. It's a really great unit. If you're having any questions or issues with the book, let me know. And I can't wait to see you guys on Google Meets. Please show up. It makes me really happy, and it'll make grades really happy too. Bye, guys.